Hey, this is Yelena from Sakari, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the full ActiveCampaign and Sakari integration. Just make sure you have both of those accounts already set up. And the purpose of this first step is to connect your accounts directly inside of ActiveCampaign. This is going to allow you to send text messages inside of ActiveCampaign workflows. So you're going to come to the left navigation pane and find where it says apps. In the search box up at the top right, type in Sakari, and you're going to see the Sakari SMS box. Once you click that, you're going to see something like this, where it's going to allow you to connect accounts. Simply click that Connect Account button, and it'll ask you for your Sakari login credentials. Once you provide those, your accounts will be connected. Now, for one-on-one text messaging to ActiveCampaign contacts directly inside of Sakari, there's a separate setup. You're going to sign into Sakari and go to Integrations in the left-hand navigation pane and find where it says ActiveCampaign. It's going to ask you for this API key and API URL. The place where you can find that is inside of ActiveCampaign. So we're going to go back to our ActiveCampaign profile and find Settings. Go to Developer, and you're going to see this URL and key. You're going to copy and paste those in their appropriate fields in Sakari. That's the most important part. These other things are listed as optional. So for timeline inbound and timeline outbound events, you'll want to turn this on if you want to see a note on the contact's profile when a message is sent or received. So let's say I was in Sakari, sent a message here to Joe Brown, type in the message, press send. If you have those two items on, you'll see the contact note here on the side in ActiveCampaign of the message that was sent and the messages that were received. Now, if you enable opt-in, opt-out, all this does is just show you these two fields here, when a contact was opted in, and if the contact opts out, you'll be able to see that information here. And last but not least, you can turn this received message information on for some more in-depth insight on received messages. So what this does is create 7 additional custom fields inside of ActiveCampaign with just some deeper information on these messages. So the price, the received ID, etc. And once you've turned on all of these, you don't have to if you don't want to, but once you do, all you have to do is press save, and you've successfully set up the full ActiveCampaign integration. Thanks for watching.